Light of the Jedi by Charles Soule is the first novel set in the new High Republic era of Star Wars. I'll be honest, I had a lot of hopes going into this book and this entire publishing effort. I've been excited for the chance to dive into new characters and new settings and a new take on the Jedi and the Republic with a new villain and a part of the Star Wars timeline that hasn't ever really been covered. So, did Light of the Jedi meet my expectations? Not only did it meet, but I would say it greatly exceeded them. This is immediately one of my favorite Star Wars books of all time, both canon and legends. I don't know what it is about Soule and the way he writes Star Wars, but he just speaks to me. It doesn't matter if he's writing comics or novels, normal people of the galaxy or Jedi, good guys or bad, it all just screams Star Wars to me. He balances the new with the familiar effortlessly. I can't imagine a better setup to the High Republic to get me so invested in everything that's happening. Let's start by talking about the Great Disaster, because that has been touted as the event that kicks off the entire storytelling world of the era, and I won't be getting into spoilers today, so don't worry about that. But the opening chapters of this book are so intense and engaging and exciting, but also do all the heavy lifting introducing our new heroes both within the Jedi Order and the Republic. And there are a lot of new Jedi, but they all feel unique and they're all likable for different reasons and have their own struggles. The same with the regular, everyday people of the Republic. It doesn't matter who he's writing, but Soule makes you fall in love with so many people very quickly. And then, you know, because this is a disaster, some of them are lost, and I felt it even early on. I can't count the amount of times I uttered, dank ferric to myself while reading this book, except I didn't say dank ferric. I talk a lot about the scene in The Force Awakens where Finn and Poe first meet. One of my favorite things is meeting new characters and falling in love with them, and that scene really sold me on who those characters were and their relationship, and I was immediately rooting for them. Light of the Jedi does that over and over and over. The Great Disaster is one of the coolest, most creative openings I can remember in a Star Wars book in a long time. Something I feel like I've been saying for years now is that I want the book side of the universe to be able to tell larger stories. I've certainly enjoyed many Star Wars books since 2015, but many of them felt like they existed to support the movies or animated shows. I loved stories like Thrawn and Phasma, but they were focused on just one character and were released as tie-ins for Star Wars Rebels or The Last Jedi. I've been missing the days of Legends where, even if the New Jedi Order and the Yuuzhan Vong had mixed reception, we were really expanding the universe instead of just exploring things we already knew. Light of the Jedi feels like a Legends book. It's not restricted by the movies or the TV shows or any of the surrounding content because there isn't any. The books used to be the backbone of the Star Wars universe. That's how we learned more about new threats, new conflicts, new characters, and so on. I don't know if that's going to change down the line, but for now, the books and comics are once again the backbone of at least one area of Star Wars. They are the driving force of expanding Star Wars instead of just recontextualizing it, and it shows. So let's talk about that new era. We're 200 years before any of the films. I do think the way it's presented might take some getting used to for some people. There's a bit of a joke with the Legends Old Republic era. Everything looks different, but basically acts exactly the same, despite being 4,000 years before the movies. There's no big technological difference. The High Republic doesn't feel super different on the surface. I wouldn't say the technology is something they're trying to highlight, like, look how different this is. But it does seem different, if you're like me and you're looking for that. But I didn't find it to be distracting at all. I enjoyed it. I'm curious how that will make the galaxy look when we do jump thousands of years in the past, but in the context of the High Republic, I'm really digging it. What does actively feel different, as in the differences are highlighted, is the Republic itself. As the title of the era would suggest, this is kind of when it's at its most ideal. It's got a chancellor who truly cares. It's got citizens who truly care. The Jedi don't seem like they are distant and disconnected from the people they're meant to protect. I loved how it all felt. I've been speculating that this series might be like the beginning of the downfall of both the Jedi and the Republic. I still think that's true, but now I also see it as a real tragedy. But at the same time, especially looking back at the real world and the way 2020 went, it gave me a lot of hope. I mean, we are seeing a terrible disaster unfold across the galaxy, and there's a government in place that cares, that wants to do everything it can to protect every endangered life. It's really nice to read a story about various groups of people coming together, to work together, to do everything they can to help. The politicians don't back down in the face of political or economic pressure. They make decisions with the interest of all their citizens in mind. It felt like a story, at least I, really needed at this point in time. And it sucks that it's all going to degrade, but let's look at one of the possible causes of the eventual downfall of the Republic and the Jedi, the Nile. They are awesome villains. I'm not going to go into too much detail about who they are or how they operate because that's all really fun to discover on your own, but rest assured, they are different, and I'm thrilled about that. If the Sith are all about power and domination, the Nile are almost like the extreme opposite of that. Total freedom, but a freedom that's twisted and gone too far. Freedom to take what you want and destroy what you want. Freedom from consequence. They're chaotic, but with enough order to keep them interesting. I liked their structure, their leaders, the big bad, and their motivations, both those that are clear and those that are not. And they're an enemy that challenges the Jedi Order and the Republic. A big theme of the Clone Wars series is about how the Jedi lost their way, and part of that was participating in the fighting at all. So I was curious how this conflict would be any different. How would the Jedi take part? So much of Star Wars is about when it's right and necessary to stand and fight, and I'm glad that wasn't at all ignored here. There are also plenty of mysteries and dangling threads established in Light of the Jedi that make me so excited for the future, because this isn't just a one-off book, this is the first in a series. I felt satisfied by the story that was told and the arcs of the characters, but I was also plenty intrigued and excited about what's to come, which I assume will be picked up primarily in Kevin Scott's novel The Rising Storm coming out this July. And of course, there are also connections to the other books and the comics that are just about to begin, but they don't dominate the story. This book very easily could have felt like all set up for what's to come, but it doesn't. It feels like its own thing. A complete and thrilling story through and through with new, fantastic characters that I can't wait to learn more about. And on top of all that, it's a story that has something to say. A story that offers new insights into what it means to be a Jedi, or in a more practical, real-world sense, what it means to be a power for good. Light of the Jedi has immediately become one of my favorite Star Wars books of all time. I need to just sit with it a little longer, but I could see it being a frontrunner for my favorite Star Wars book, period. I connect so much with how Charles Soule writes Star Wars, but it also sets up the kind of storytelling I have been waiting for in the new Star Wars canon. If you're like me in that sense, get this book. If you're a fan of the Jedi, I think you'll love the new directions this book explores. I absolutely cannot wait for this series to continue. If you want to check out Light of the Jedi for yourself, consider picking it up for free on Audible. Just follow the link in the description or visit www.audibletrial.com/StarWarsExplained. The audiobook is out right now, and the production value on all the Star Wars books is very high with sound effects and music. It's like listening to a movie. Signing up for an Audible trial will get you a credit for one free book, and you can use it on Light of the Jedi or the other High Republic books, A Test of Courage or Into the Dark, or just about any Star Wars book you can think of. Or get any book you want. The point is, you get a free book, and you'll be supporting the channel when you do. But that's it for today. I would love to hear what you think of Light of the Jedi when you read it, so let me know down in the comments. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to the channel to keep up with all our High Republic coverage, follow us on Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and consider checking out our Patreon page. As always, thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.